people, how are you today? Today a totally different video than what I normally make. It still has to do with jewelry, but this time I'm going to show you a totally different technique. I hope you really like this. This is how to use focal beads with some chainmail. And this is just one part because we're going to make the other part today. This is with a pink one, and I use some aluminum pink chainmail, so pink rings. You can also use it if you don't have chainmail rings or colored chainmail rings. You can totally use just jump rings in the same size, so that really doesn't matter. And I made these green ones just to show you that you can also like this one is just a chainmail and then attached to the ear hook, but you can also use the chainmail in between the beads. It is just what you like. This is not hard, but you have to get the pattern like any other kind of jewelry. But this is mainly how to get how to make the pattern. So the materials we're going to need. We're going to need some of the chainmail rings, and these are, I believe, 6mm rings. These are, as I said, aluminum jump rings. You can also use the normal jump rings, as I said, just what you have, but I use these pink ones. You will need a focal bead, and of course I'm going to, because I already made the other one, you're going to double the amount of things you need. You're going to need a focal bead so that you can make the piece really stand out. I use this smaller bead. You can also leave this aside, but you're just going to make your own focal bead and then the things you like with them. What I also used is these bead caps, and I use these bead caps on top and on the bottom. Sorry, keep dropping them. On the top and on the bottom of the bead. So bead caps, two bead caps. I'm going to use this very small, I'm going to use this very small bead to attach at the end of my head pin, because I don't want my bead to fall out, because the holes of these beads can be a little larger than the head pin. So I'm going to use a bead to stop that. And you will need an ear hook so that you can hook it on. Of course, you can also make a necklace out of this, but I'm just going to show you how to make the earrings. And you will need some pliers. I use a cutting plier, two flat nose pliers, and it doesn't matter if they're like this, the very big flat ones, or that you use the small flat ones. It's just what you like. And I'm going to use the round nose plier. So cutting plier and two pieces of no teeth pliers. You really need ones without teeth, because you don't want to scratch your jump rings. And the round nose plier. Now, first thing we're going to do, we're going to make the bottom piece of this earring. So we're going to take our head pin. We're going to place the ball on it. And then we're going to take the bead cap, and we're going to do the pretty side downwards, because the bead will come on the top of this. Then we're going to take our focal bead. And now we're going to take the bead cap, and now we're going to place the ugly side downwards. So the non-pretty side. I wouldn't say ugly side, but you know what I mean. And then we're going to place the bead on top of that. So you're just going to make a sequence that you like. As I said, with the other ones, you can also make something in between. You can also put two focal beads underneath each other and then make the chainmail. It is just what you like. Now, I'm going to take my cutting pliers now. And I'm going to cut above the last bead about 1 centimeter. Like this. And then I'm going to take my round nose plier, and I'm going to make a loop. And just make your own loop like you would make a regular loop. There's no right or wrong about this. So it looks like this. And now we're going to leave this aside for now. Now we're going to take our rings, and you don't need as much as I have here, but I just like to work with a few. Now, normally with chainmail, people are going to talk about closed and open rings. But for the sake of this tutorial, and because I wanted this to be able to use for beginners, I'm going to show you just ring by ring. So we're going to use all open rings. I'm sorry if I say wrong, but I believe this is the Byzantine. This is the Byzantine kind of chainmail, and you can use this in between almost everything. And that is why I wanted to show you this, because this can give your jewelry just that little extra that it makes it more special than regular jewelry. We're going to take our rings and we're going to take our pliers, so the pliers without the teeth, and we're going to open them. And when you're going to open them, do this straight. So you're going to pick up your ring, and you're going to bend it straight. So don't bend them open, you're going to twist them. Now I'm going to do this a few times, and I'm sorry I didn't really count my rings, so I can't really say how many times. I'm sorry, not properly prepared, but if you open them and you don't need them afterwards, it doesn't matter, because you can just use them later. So I opened a few, and now I'm going to take my my piece, so my focal bead, and I'm going to attach the first one on the ring, and I'm going to zoom in from this moment on. Here I'm a little bit tired, sorry. Okay, and then we're going to close this one. And the thing is with chainmail, it is really important that you close it properly, because you don't want you to come your work undone afterwards. Sorry. Now I'm going to take my my ring again, another ring, and I'm going to attach it to the same ring. So you will have two rings on your piece now. And I'm going to show you this. So as you can see, you have, I hope my camera goes in focus, you have two rings on your piece now. Now we're going to take another ring, and we're going to place this ring, we're going to place this ring on the two rings we now just added. So I'm going to take my two rings, and I'm going to take a new ring, and I'm going to hook this on my two rings. Like this. And then close it up. And again, I'm going to take a new ring, and I'm going to place this in the two rings, just like we did before. So now we have two rings holding two rings. And I'm going to show you that again. And I'm sorry if I have dirty hands, I just made a tutorial with alcohol markers and I can't rub that off in one day, so sorry. So that's why I have all kinds of spots and things, just alcohol markers, sorry. I'm a really crafty girl. As you can see, now I have two rings on my two rings. Like this. Okay, now what we're going to do, and I believe I do this a little different from the people I see this on YouTube. We're going to grab the two bottom rings, and we're going to flip one ring to one side and one ring to the other side. And then I'm going to take a plier. You can use any plier for this, but I use the flat plier without the teeth. And then what we're going to do, we're going with our plier, we're going in between the two rings that are just sticking up, so not the ones that lay flat, but the ones that sticking up. And I'm going to pick up the two rings we just laid flat in the middle. So I'm going to try to zoom this in as good as I can. I hope you can see this. I'm picking up the two rings in the middle. So like this. And what I'm then going to do, I'm going to hold this, and if you do this correctly, it stands like this. And I'm going to pick up one of my rings, and I'm going through the two in the middle that we just held up like this. And I'm sorry if I'm going out of focus, but I need to grab my plier. And then we're going to close this ring up. Like this. And then we're going to grab another ring. I'm sorry, this is a little hard to show maybe. Like this. And you can see this is the ring we just added. And now I'm going to take the second ring and I'm going through the same two middle rings. So just the two middle rings. Like this. And then I'm going to close this ring up. Like this. And now we have something like this. I'm going to grab this for you. Now you can see that we have our first piece of chainmail on, and we have two rings to hold it up. Like this. Now I'm going to open four more rings. As I said, I didn't count up front how many I need. But I'm just going to open four more rings. And I hope this was easily to follow. Like this. Then I'm going to grab the two rings that are holding my first piece of chainmail up, and I'm going to grab them. Like this. And then I'm just going to add two more rings on top of that two rings. I hope I can stay in focus, so I'm just going to close these up and grab another ring and hook it on those same two rings. And I'm going to let them dangle. You can see that you have your piece of the piece that stands out already, the two pieces that are on top of that, and then you have two rings on top of them. And we're going to add another pair, so two rings on the top rings. I'm sorry if I'm out of focus sometimes, but this is really centimeter work, so I have like 2x4 centimeters to film. Like this. And I hope you can see correctly. I have now three of the rings on, so six of the rings on. Here two, there two, and on the top two. So. What we're going to do now, we're going to grab on to the first ring from the piece that we already made. Just with our hands, like this. And then we're going to do the same as we did before. And, oh, sorry, almost forgot something. We're going to grab our ear hook. And we're going to open this. So the bottom of the ear hook, we're going to open this. And because we're going to hook our chainmail on this hook. Now we're going to grab onto our middle, just like we did before, sorry. So I have my piece here and I'm going to grab the middle, like this. And then I'm going to lay the top rings on the side, like this. And then again, I'm going to use my plier. I'm going in between the two middle rings, and I'm going to grab those rings on the inside that were just laid to the outside, if you do understand what it means. So I'm going to pick up it like this. And then we get something like this. And now I'm going to hold this. I'm going to grab my ear hook and I'm going to grab those middle rings like this, and now I'm going to close the ear hook up. So just like you would close your regular ear hook, I'm just going to close that up. And there you have your earring. And I'm going to zoom out now. Like this. So, I hope this was easily to follow. I'm sorry if it still was a little bit confusing, but I hope this was easily to follow. This is just a very simple and easy and very, very beginner's way to use some chainmail into your earrings and make them look just a little bit more special than when you would do it with in the normal way. So I hope you really like this, and I'm sorry that this week is not a very very big tutorial or something, but I still hope you like this. So I hope to see you soon, and please give me a thumbs up if you like this video, subscribe to my channel if you like this video, and all my social media links and things like that are in the info box, so you can, if you like to follow me on something, you can follow me, you can find it there. So I hope you like this. Please show me a photo on Facebook if you tried this, and I'll see you the next time. Bye.